feel me, bro?
Yep.
That's the same shit with Munchie.
I tell niggas
Munchie, that you be anywhere shit with me, nigga, this is my brother. Just like, you, bro, from Queens can vouch for you. You feel
yeah, on the real.
On my mama,
I speak on that shit every time.
I don't play them. It ain't no, I'm going to ever cross a nigga. I'm going to ever, you my brother, nigga, you my brother. Straight up from the get.
Who you talking to, AD?
I'm talking to Munch.
Munch, where you from, Munch?
You feel me?
From Englewood.
Englewood what? AD, where you from?
I'm from 6-0 Crip.
And you was just telling Munch what? Say it one more time.
Munch, we anywhere, homie, I got you. Period. And I, man, everybody know me. Everybody know I don't joke or play.
Yes, sir.
Munch with me, you got a problem with him, you ain't going to have no problem with him. Or it's going to be a problem with me.
Yes, sir.
That's just it. That's
right.
That's it. There ain't no other way, and that's like, bro. All right,
where you from?
Remy, bro, know what's up. You feel
huh?
Me?
I'm 20.
Yes, sir. That's my partner right there. Yes, indeed.
Yeah, man.
So, look, man, what I got right here, I got America's most hated in this room right here, right? I got the people that, for real, look, I got the motherfuckers that people really afraid of. Really afraid of in this room right here. I got them. And they sitting down together talking about, I got you. If you with me, I got you.
Straight
you
like
got that?
See, even if you ain't with me, you can
man,
hit my line.
Man, straight up.
Hit my line and we'll figure it out.
We'll figure it out from there.
Yes, sir.
We'll figure it out, homie.
That's a beautiful thing. Munchie, man, how you feel about this? Because, you know, let me tell you something. I'm going to have to put Munchie on blast. Because last year when we was doing all this, there was only one person I was thinking about, like, how in the fuck am I going to get to Munchie? We doing something really positive, really good. And my only fear was, damn, there's one dude who could shut it down. And everybody was like, hey, Skip, call his daddy. Call his daddy, right? And I'm like, nah, I don't want to call that nigga daddy. I want to have a one-on-one conversation with him and see if I can get him to join circles like this.
Nah, he's from
Swans. He's from Swans, but he the influence.
Yeah.
You know, they figure like if I call his daddy will influence him, right? Yeah. And look, a year later, look who right here, y'all. That's a beautiful thing, that's brother. How you feel, man? Being a part of this group, man, you know you in the room right now with some dudes that people don't really like, man, but how you feel?
Shit, it's smooth, but last year, I felt like, man, everybody was on Crenshaw slots and they wasn't genuine. They was there for the clout. Or cause it was popping over here. Like females, you know what I'm saying? That's your chance to talk to females you couldn't talk to because they live in the mm-hmm. ops or whatever. So if they wasn't genuine, I wasn't about to be over there. You know what I'm saying? Fake cool my young and they ain't genuine about what they talking about. You know what I mean?
Yes, sir. But as of right now,
but
man,
if a person genuine, if they really about what they talking about, and serious, you know what I'm saying? I don't mind, but I ain't with the little faking and shaking. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir. So, look, now this room that we got right here, man, just, you know, I'm going to highlight just you and Lil AD, man. Mm-hmm. Do you think it's possible that maybe in a couple weeks, man, if you grab somebody, matter of fact, Firebug for one, I want Firebug, but maybe somebody else, and do you think that if you grab somebody, AD, just two dudes, man, and we go sit down and eat, what would that look like? What you think?
Grabbing
like this. My shit is credibility, homie. I don't fuck all that clout shit and all that, bro. I ain't with all that.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You want to come fuck with me, bro? You more than welcome, homie.
So this look, so I'm saying I wanna put something together where just like two dudes. It ain't gotta be the whole neighborhood. Just two dudes. Can we sit down?
We start off little.
Just two dudes. And then in that conversation.
Yeah.
With them two dudes, we could talk about what two dudes aren't here. What two dudes need to be here to make this shit work. That's all I want to do is have a conversation. I don't even want to say nothing. Matter of fact, I'm going to buy the chicken.
First, you know
and
what?
I'm going to start eating.
First, you know what? Me and Munch, we're going to start off with just me and Munch.
That's it.
Right now.
Yes, sir.
You know what I'm saying?
That's a beautiful thing.
Start our own relationship first.
Yeah.
And then we can go on to bringing this nigga in and he can bring his nigga in and we go from there.
Yeah?
You know?
Because a year ago, this wasn't happening, huh?
No,
not last year for me,
though.
No. Not last year.
Nah, yeah, you know what I'm saying? You just got to be sincere about what you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Nah, this is a beautiful thing, brother. I appreciate both of y'all, man. I love y'all, man. Ain't no way in the world. Ever see, ain't no way in the world I could answer the phone when Munchie call and be like, hey, nah, I love you, homie. and then hang up and have to call AD and be like, I love you, homie, but y'all don't love each other. Yeah. To me, that would make me disingenuous. Yeah. That would make me the fake dude. Yeah. If I'm on the phone with both of y'all and I got love for both of y'all, but y'all ain't never sat down and gathered love.
You ain't took the steps to mend them, to bring all the love as one. Then you feel some way. You're doing the right thing right now. You own it, though. For real. You got it.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
It's a process, though.
Yeah. It's a process. Man, now what I got to do is make the world love nephew, man. The world got a love nephew right there behind you. The world got to love him, man. I don't know how I'm going to do that, man. What I'm going to do? Tell me, man. You got all the answers, KB.
I got all the motherfucking answers.
You do, man.
I stand stronger until I can't stand strong no more. And I get a gun, you know.
Yeah. So straight up.
Okay, well, that wasn't the answer. I wasn't looking for that answer. But, yeah.
Nigga got to be that self, man. That's the only shit that's going to make it genuine. You feel me?
Yeah.
That's it. That's what's going to make it real. Nigga being himself, that's I don't got no ill feelings towards Munchie ass feeling. Like, he supposed to feel like that. Right. This nigga a real gangbanger. I feel like that. I'm a real gangbanger. You feel me? But I just know that at the same time.
You got to go in a different direction.
Yeah, exactly. I done did the proof with the pudding. You feel me?
Yeah.
I done had bloods over there in my hood and made them be safe. You feel me? And ain't no discrimination. Ain't no, I don't give a fuck, man. It ain't nothing to prove with me. You feel me?
You imagine going to their park, bro?
On my mom.
What about 200-300 of them?
You know what I'm saying? And I mean, it's different. And it's all different crip hoods.
I ain't gonna lie. I'm I didn't imagine it either.
Yeah.
I was like, fuck out of here, man. I mean, don't get me wrong. I know niggas from 60 that I slid through and fucked with. I ain't gonna say no names.
Yeah, I feel
like I'm about work over there. I was on Brownhurst in and out with a female. Yeah. Came out about 6 in the morning. What they call Toy, I forgot what they call Ripper.
Yeah, huh?
He come out, he come here, what you doing over here? He thought I was crazy, he thought I was nerdy. I'm like, I'm over here visiting this broad. He like,
I knew Bert and all of them too.
I ain't gonna lie, it tripped me out. And I'm looking at you, bro. Like, I don't know your name like that. And I know niggas from 60 that I'm solid with, that I fuck with. I know Spank, I know Mayhem, I'm my niggas, you know what I'm saying?
That's right.
So if one of them niggas told me, you good, KB, you been different, I'm like, I'm good.
Yeah.
With my burn on me, I'm still, I'm good. And if you get into it with one of your homies, you got to know that I'm busting with you.
Yeah.
So, you know what I'm saying?
So it's the same exact.
So when I'm looking at you, I'm like, I don't know this dude.
Yeah.
You telling me I'm good. Like, man, Skip had left me in some good hands because I ain't shaking.
Yeah.
And I'm posted. And I got the homies with me and shit. Just so happened you knew Slick, you know what I'm saying, or whatever. And that was, like, wavy for me, too.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You know?
Because you and the boy don't,
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, so, I let it be what it be.
So, let me tell you what happened. So, AD is talking to the 40, so I want to give a shout-out to Tiny Blue and Iceman. Iceman's supposed to be here with us, but his car at the shop, so he couldn't make it, right?
Yeah.
But when I'm walking over there where he is, I'm walking with Big U from 60s. Worldwide, everybody know Big U, right? So, I'm telling AD, when we get over there, I say, man, you know who you are. You're going to be the next Big U. You're going to be the next Skip. And Bear Claw started laughing. And he said, nah, Skip, he's that right now. He's the one right now. He's Big U and Skip put together. I'm like, man. And I was telling Big U, man, you better go over there and say something, man. They talking about peace. And Big U sat down in the chair, and he leaned back. He said, AD got it. He got it. That's when I was like, damn. Who is this AD dude? Because I'm just looking at face value like, okay, this the youngster that's doing this shit, but they both told me, nah, he's the one. So I was like, shit, that's why I told you. Nah, you good. You with AD. You with the one. So, but here's the thing. So now let me move over to Inglewood, though. Because for years I was chasing Tiny Munchie ever since he was in juvenile hall, right? His grandmama, his uncles, everybody got me chasing this dude. So I'm chasing him all around. And when I put something together with the Hunnets and Inglewood families, Rod Dog brought a few dudes with him. And they just kept saying, oh, this dude called himself the General, Tiny Munchie. He jumps out the car. He chased old people, Skip. He said, man, dude, your age, man, got asthma and shit. Man, we can't run from him. Next thing you know, Tiny Munchie come in. The thing is, there's a big Munchie. They got a whole bunch of little Munchies behind him. And when he say shit, there's lady Munchies and all that. I'm like, man, I got to have him. He's the way to get peace.
Yeah.
And look what I got. Y'all see him right there? That's the big Munchie. So even though I'm still in contact with Tiny Munchie and talked to his grandmama and his uncle, Marlon, a couple weeks ago or whatever, to me, this is major. This is how we bring peace, by getting the influencers. You know, I want to say the people who are of an influence to sit at the table and use their influence to build relationships. I'm not saying to not be from Inglewood family, because for me, it's I till I die. I'm from Inglewood family. I till I die. I'm not saying not to be from 60s. You know, shit, man, Slauson and Crenshaw, whatever your street is, that's it. You know, but the thing is, but here's the thing. But I ain't got to kill you, and you ain't got to kill me. That's the only thing I'm saying.
Respect me and I'm going to respect you.
Man,
you said Spain, infant Spain. You talking about infant Spain?
Yeah.
You know, that's my brother.
See? That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah, I used to go to school over there. That's my man, man.
Infant Spain from 60s?
Yeah.
Jamal. That's my little cousin. Munchie, my blood little cousin.
Yeah, that's my daughter. I went to catch. My man went there.
On God in heaven, that's my blood little cousin.
I got his number on my phone.
Yeah. That's crazy. That's my blood little cousin. His mama is my mama's older sister.
Jamal Bowman.
Yeah, Jamal Bowman.
Yeah, that's my
dog.
So
ain't that something?
So this is God work.
Oh, yeah, this is God work, man.
How you gonna start a home relationship though?
Yep. So look, I'm gonna let everybody end this video for me, man. What you wanna end it with, man? What you wanna say to the people watching, man? Because it's some powerful shit. I just let
wake the fuck up, everybody.
Wake the fuck up.
That's it.
What you wanna end with?
Likewise, wake the fuck up. Move forward.
Yeah, I'm gonna go to you. I'm gonna end with you. Come on, Munchie. What you wanna end this video with? What you want people to know?
It's a process. You gotta start somewhere. You know what I mean? Don't try to force it. Like you said, start with me and him. You ain't gotta bring a lot of people that ain't genuine about it. So, you know, eventually it just trickled down.
Yes, sir.
Let me say this one thing that Munchie said though. You ain't genuine. Stay the fuck away. Plain and simple. I don't give a fuck if you from 60s or you from Inglewood. It don't matter to me.
Right.
On the real.
You ain't genuine. Stay away. Yeah. All right, come on, man. What you going to lead the world with, man? I need you to make some powerful statement, man. What you going to lead the world with, man?
For all respect one another.
That's it.
Respect one another? All right. Well, I appreciate y'all, brothers, man. I think this was a powerful meeting right here. Inglewood and Slauson and Crenshaw sitting down, along with some West Adams and other Inglewood participants. So thank y'all for that.
Shit, if us four can do it, y'all can do it. Y'all niggas ain't harder than us.
Right. No, I can guarantee. That's just real. I can guarantee. You know, I don't want to put nobody business out there, but the real ones is in this room right here.
Oh, my mama.
Yeah.